In this exercise, we're going to follow the movement of chromosomes through the process of mitosis. Now, recall that the DNA is replicated before mitosis begins. It's replicated in interphase, specifically in S phase of interphase. So we notice that the chromosomes are already in the X shape, meaning they have two sister chromatids that are exact copies of one another. We begin with prophase, and what we're noticing is that the chromosomes are distinct, so the chromatin has condensed into chromosomes. There isn't any particular order or pattern that these chromosomes are present in. Now, also, the nuclear envelope is beginning to disappear, and we see the formation of the spindle apparatus from the centrosomes. In metaphase, we see the chromosomes being moved to the equator, or the middle of the cell, and they are single file. In anaphase, the duplicated chromosomes are going to be separated, so the two sister chromatids are pulled in opposite directions to opposite poles of the cell. In telophase, the chromosomes now, they are considered sister chromatids when they are connected at the centromere. Once they are separated, they are chromosomes. So these chromosomes arrive at the opposite poles, and the opposite of prophase occurs. The nuclear envelope begins to form, the spindle apparatus breaks down, and the chromosomes decondense back into chromatin. Cytokinesis occurs during telophase. It's different for animal and plant cells. For animal cells, we see a cleavage furrow occurring where it looks as though the cell is pinched into until we have a separation of the plasma membrane into two different cells.